Okay, let's get back to the small intestine where we left off. We talked about digestion from beginning to end, but we still have to talk about absorption. The small intestine is a very long organ with folds on the inside. On the folds are villi and microvilli. Now, why in the world does the small intestine need to have this very long organ with folds and villi? The answer is surface area. Imagine if your small intestine was flat inside. It would look something like this. But if the villi, with the villi and folds, it looks something like this. Now, if you were to pull this line taut, it would stretch out much further. See how the surface area increases by having the folds and villi? We need to have the increased surface area because we need every chance for absorption to occur. Absorption occurs in the lining of the villi. The nutrients cross the cells of the intestine into the transport systems inside. It does us no good to eat food if the nutrients are not going to be absorbed into the body. The digestive tract is one big open tube from mouth to anus. We have some sphincters along the way, but the tube is open. It does us no good if it goes in one end and out the other. The cells, organs, and processes necessary to life are not located inside the GI tract. We have to get the nutrients out of the GI tract and into the transport systems to carry nutrients to cells in the body. That is what absorption is about. We want every chance we can to absorb nutrients, hence the long tube with folds and villi. The good news is that the cells on the brush border of the intestine are very picky. They will only allow entrance to very specific things it recognizes that are in the form it requires. Therefore, undigested particles will not pass through. There are some disease states that may interfere with this, including some inflammatory conditions that lead to what is called leaky gut. When the nutrients are absorbed, they enter into one of two transport systems. We have the circulatory system represented in red and blue. This is the primary route to transport nutrients to cells. And the lymphatic system is represented in yellow. The nutrients that are water-soluble, such as amino acids, sugars, and water-soluble vitamins, will enter into the bloodstream or circulatory system. Fats and fat-soluble vitamins will enter into the lymphatic system. This graphic shows an overview of the two systems. The blue and red shows the circulatory system. If you look closely at the digestive system, you will see that all of the bloodstream coming from the digestive tract goes to the liver first. There is a specific reason for this that we will discuss later. After the liver, blood goes to the heart and lungs to be sent to all of the tissue in the body. The lymphatic system is designated as a light peach color. It bypasses the liver from the digestive tract. Fats will be packaged up in the lymphatic system so they can be transported in blood. Eventually, the nutrients in the lymphatic system will enter the bloodstream near the heart, and those nutrients will join the others in the bloodstream so it can be pumped from the heart to the cells of the body.